So far we've been doing segmentation as clustering, and we've been using some feature space based upon color, and then we have these different algorithms. One of the challenges is that things like just color or the brightness or position, which is something else we looked at, alone are not enough to do segmentation. Here are some examples. So you can see that, you know, generally in this area here, the colors are about the same as this area there. Likewise, the brightness here, the average brightness is the same as the brightness over there. Now, you have no problem seeing the differences between these, but that's because you just don't use brightness, position, color. You also use texture, right? Obviously, the texture here is different than the texture there. Likewise, on the fawn, the texture there is quite different than the texture here. So the question is, how would we introduce some measure that was sensitive to texture into our segmentation? One way of thinking about texture is this. So here I have this picture, okay, and I've got clearly different texture here than I do here and I do there. All right. So here is one approach. Let's compute a series of filter outputs. So here's it, 24, it says 24 right there. Here's 24 different filters, okay? And they may have different orientation, so here we get different orientations. And they have different scales, so they go from a coarser scale to a finer scale, and here's ones that are just sort of little center surround. It almost doesn't matter, well, it does matter, but it almost doesn't matter which filters you use. The idea is that you're creating a new set of dimensions that you'll have for every point, right? And when you do that, the idea is that hopefully along these different dimensions, and there's 24 of them, however many you have, you would get some clusters depending upon the types of textures that you have in your image. And that's what's being shown here, right? Is you have these clusters in this image space, all right? And so here's an example of using, let's just suppose we take a look at, this is the derivative in the x direction. So how much gradient there is going in the x direction at one particular scale. This is one of the dimensions. And this is in the y direction, so it's your measure your gradient in the y direction. And the idea is that, well, in this case, there are little areas that have, in this case, windows that primarily have vertical edges, right? Because they've got strong x gradient and no y gradient. Likewise, here's horizontal. This has a little window that would have a texture in both of them. And these would be areas that have hardly any gradient at all.